Welcome back, and welcome to the best week of the year. That's right, it is Paris Roubaix week. So I thought what we'd do today is something very, very different. 2011, I did the Paris Roubaix challenge, which was the sportif the day before the Paris Roubaix pro race. It was the first ever mass participation event I had ever done. And I documented it because I'm Chris. And so I thought today I would show you that documentary. This is potential. I've been sitting on this for a while. I haven't been sure whether to show it because it's dodgy, right? It's not my greatest piece of work, but I kind of thought from a couple of reasons, right? Because, you know, a few of you have asked, like, how did I get into cycling and this sort of thing, and it shows a little bit of that progression and sort of what was happening at the time with me. But also, I think it's just a really good opportunity to laugh at me. Some outfits. Outfits being worn here. Don't be too harsh in the comments, all right? I do have some self-esteem I would like to keep. There we go. 2011 Paris Roubaix Challenge. Go.
Early starts still meant that temperatures were low.
Two or three degrees, but as long as it stays dry, especially up around Sunny Gap, we should be okay. I'm not sure I'm going to pull up after this, because this is the first long ride, so first step to the cobbles, I suppose.
And if you want your friends to come here, really try, maybe we will find a rainbow and teach it to fly.
How are we feeling?
Feeling like it was a tough 60 for an easy 60. First session back of 2011. Another patch on what Paris Roubaix is going to be for Mark and Chris. I don't envy what you boys are going to go through down below.
Massive setback over the weekends. Didn't get out on the bike after coming back from Brussels. And what's worse is managed to twist the ankle again, playing tag this time. So I was on crutches yesterday and today, but hopefully being a bike, I'm going to be able to manage. So putting the gear on, I'm going to head out with Owen and Mark and put the ankle through some tests, because I'm going to need to get some miles in really badly. Alright, this is the Nocturnal 100.
Who wants to know all that is gone? Is rusted, gone. And if not some, they somehow are.
Still deep into a winter season that had seen Dublin gripped with record snowfalls and freezing temperatures. Training then presented its own challenges. It was either indoors or make use of the record snowfalls.
It's turns. Last week I cycled down this road. This week I ski down it.
Deck, I can't believe you're letting Chris ski on. Don't go too fast, Chris.
So it's a rainy Tuesday night in Dublin. We're planning to do 100Ks, but not going to do it. So we're going to head up to the combat session and hopefully get something done tonight.
Good.
After 4 months of training through sleet, snow and ice, it was time for the Queen of the Classics. So it was left to Mark and myself to go from Paris to Roubaix.
Stay super late tonight. Pick an apple, we're half awake in a fake empire. We're half awake in a fake empire.
Yeah, we got rolled out.
Okay.
Roll out.
After 160 kilometres, 40 of which were on 16 separate cobbled sections, we made it.
Yay! Well done, guys!
Honestly, the cobbles were horrible. Not in an exhausting, really long climb way, but in it, you've just been beaten up by someone in a ring way. The thick coating of Roubaix dust was all we had to show for our achievements.
It started off fast for the first K, then a little pitch. Then
we're tired, caught up. And the cobbles, which we strangely excelled at, I think. But it's still pretty brutal.
I think it was grim.
I don't think it really sums it up.
Did you get some pints?
Yeah.
The next day, we'd watch the pros do a race 100 kilometres longer, but on very much the same cobbled stretches. And what made us feel brilliant was they looked just as shattered as we felt.
Oh, it's been so long, been so long. Fate has a way of showing I'm waiting along. Oh, it's been so long.
It's been so long, been so long. Time has a way of knowing. Oh, it's been so long.
Got your apology ready?
I'm feeling better. A little bit nervous about this now. It's been a while. It's been a while since we faced the wraps.
It's organic food, but let me tell you, it's fucking terrifying.
We're going to have to blow about 50 quid in here.
Just
Don't be too mean. I'll explain all of it in an upcoming vlog. Hope you enjoyed it.